23. Tonight, I'm going to be speaking on this subject, what is Now, this is what the Lord calls the weightier matters. This is not what some preacher and the Lord knew this was getting ready to take place. He knew his hour had finally come. Ministry, they took counsel together how they might destroy him. But this particular message in Matthew chapter, verse 1, then spake Jesus to the multitude and to his disciples, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees say, that they will never be willing to live up to. Look what they do, verse 4. For they bind heavy burdens. Of you, but they always let themselves off the hook. Verse 5, he says, all their works they do for to be seen of men. They don't know about doing any. Synagogues and greetings in the market to be called of men. Rabbi, Rabbi. They love titles. I am right, Reverend so and so. I'm Dr. With these words to these people that he's preaching to. Look in verse 33. Ye Now, in this passage of Scripture, the Lord calls these people hypocritical language. children blind. For you devour with by the temple. It's nothing, but whosoever go on, verse 18, and whosoever shall swear by the altar, it's nothing. But they were putting the emphasis on their gifts. Our text will come. Within the cup and the platter, that the outside may be clean also. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites! Graves of the righteous, and say, if we'd been in the days of our fathers, we wouldn't have been partakers with him in the blood of the prophets. Of vipers, how can you escape the damnation of hell? Now let's go to our text. You've left out the weightier matters of the law. Judgment. Text. There were a lot of sermons. You know what they were about? Tithing. Tithing. This proves. These ought ye to have done. You should have tithed just like them. Do you believe in tithing? No, I don't. Every man, Paul said, according as he purposes in his heart, so let him give. Not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves. Us. He says, you're so exact in your tithing, and I bet you they didn't give a penny more. How much you want to bet? They figured it out right down to the percentage. This is what I'm going to give. Even a matters of the law. Now this tells me that there are some things that are just more important than others. The thing that came to my mind was Martha and Mary. Remember when the Lord was coming? That is what everyone would do. And Martha was very about getting everything taken care of. And the Lord said, Martha, Martha, you're troubled about the needful necessary. Now, another very important. content is not preached, the gospel is. Hold after him, and they shall keep the way of the Lord, to do justice and judgment, that the Lord may bring upon Abraham. Sodom and Gomorrah, their sin is very grievous. I will go down now and see whether they have altogether, according to the know at this time, there are two kinds of people in this world, the righteous and verse 24, peradventure there be 50 righteous within the city. Well, Abraham demonstrates what all men know intuitively. God. Turn with me to Matthew 20, and this is the passage of Scripture that actually inspired this message. I don't think I'd ever really... the labors for a penny a day. This is 6 o'clock in the morning. He sent them out into his vineyard. And he went out about the third hour, 9 o'clock. And he went out about the 6th hour, the 9th hour, and did likewise. He came out at 12, 3, and 5 o'clock, and he said to every one of these people, whatever is right, I'll give you. They said, "Man hath hired us." He saith unto them, "Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right, you shall receive." You will get exactly. Man, a penny. But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more. I ought to get more. Verse 11, and when they had received it, the penny murmured and of the house. I do thee no wrong. He always gives what is right. I do. It is under thee not to do wrong. 12 times more than He always does that which is right. His very own and put it away. And he you that which is right. Christ took my sins. Now, this is every believer's testimony. This is every believer's testimony. They overcame right. Turn with me to John chapter 9. The cross is the manifestation of God's judgment, God's perfect righteousness. For judgment have I come into this world, that they that's the person he saves. Somebody says, well, I can see why God saved me. Look at the things I've done. No sin. That's what the Lord's work on the cross did. For sin remaineth. Can you see why God would save you? Look at all the things you've done. Look at all the things you've given up. Kind of relegated to the heap of dull and uninteresting subjects. But it's the very heart and soul of the character of God. It's the very heart and soul of the gospel. I love the way the Lord said when he proclaimed his name before Moses. He said, the Lord God. You can read this in sin. And that will by no means clear the guilty. Now that, my dear friends, is the character of the living God. Justify godly sinners like you and I. First aspect is judgment. Cross is the station. Thing that he meant is now it has been accomplished freely. He's more willing to bestow his mercy. It's all your fault. Woman, you gave me. She gave me the fruit and I did eat. No. Might stand. It's still standing. Not of works. For him to make this difference. to hate Esau? Is he not being just and right? Now, whenever we even think that, you look through his history, I mean, his name means supplanter, deceiver. And that's what he was. He deceived his brother twice. He deceived Laban. Judgment. Once judgment has been accomplished by what Christ accomplished on the cross, the gates of mercy are open. And listen. Possibly ask for mercy. But if your sin is all your fault, the only thing that will do you any good is mercy. Judgment. Mercy. You have been convinced that salvation by works for you is impossible. You have on him that justifieth the ungodly. His faith is counted for righteousness. Now, who is this person? He knows he can't be saved by his works. Justified the ungodly. With that person who believes, that's the evidence of their salvation. His faith is counted righteousness. Faith is not you believing you're saved. Faith is believing that Christ died for your sin. Faith is believing accomplished salvation. faith. Judgment. Weightier matters of the law, the of my soul's salvation. I'm persuaded Okay, 25 years ago, and what a joy! Remember this.